Hey everybody, Lance Goyke here. Today we are discussing the rhomboids in the horizontal row and different variations there. So the rhomboids are an upper back muscle. They are between your shoulder blades. They run from the middle part of the shoulder blade. So the shoulder blade is like let's see if I can make a triangle. It's kind of like a triangle. Let's do it that way. It's kind of like a triangle, and there is one part. This is my right one, right? So up here by my pointer fingers, that's where the arm runs down and comes in, connects. That's the actual shoulder joint where those two fingers are coming together. And then I have this border here that I make with my thumbs. That's called our medial border. That's the inside of the shoulder blade. So that's the one closest to your spine. And that's where the rhomboids are attaching. So those rhomboids will go from that middle part, that inside part of the shoulder blade, and then they'll connect to the spine that is running in the middle of the body. So that means if I'm doing a unilateral rowing variation, I can use that muscle, the rhomboids, to impact the spinal position, right? It helps me with some rotation because of its position here. That's a slightly more advanced topic. We're not going to talk about it too much. Primarily in the horizontal row, what I'm doing is I'm taking that shoulder blade. I'm taking both those shoulder blades. Let's say I'm doing a two-hand variation here, and I'm bringing them closer to my midline. I'm bringing them closer to the spine. And so that's the primary function of the rhomboids during the row, and that's why I should feel those muscles. Now, you can limit that motion by not bringing your shoulder blades together and kind of just pushing your shoulder joint forward while bringing your elbow back. I still get something that kind of looks like a row, but I'm putting extra stress on the actual shoulder joint because the joint there, this humerus bone, is designed to rotate with the shoulder blade. So the shoulder blade actually does like a third of your motion when you're doing that row. If I keep the shoulder blade forward, I limit how much I can do. So what happens is I'm a human and I'm task oriented, and I said, okay, I got to do this row, so I'm just going to pull really hard. Now, if I don't know how to do it with my shoulder blade, I'm going to find another way to do it. And that way generally turns into cranking down or grinding down the shoulder joint. It's probably not that bad, but it's definitely something that I would fix. So rhomboids, bringing the shoulder blades back together. I'm going to feel them more if I put the weight outside further. And so what I can do is I can flare my elbows out as I do my row, and that puts more torque on the rhomboid, because now the weight is going through my elbow. The weight is further away from where those rhomboids are trying to pull. That's just another like meathead tip for you. If you're looking to hit that muscle in particular, try flaring your elbows out a little bit more. I think that's all we need to know. That's our basics of the rhomboids during the row.